My name is Patrick. The idea of this particular video is to help you understand how can you score a 90 plus percentile in the quant section. Not difficult. I mean, you don't require too many marks to score a 90 percentile. Just focus and then you'll be able to get through. That's what is required. Let's try to understand. So we do have courses on CAT and other examinations. This basically is video for students preparing for the CAT exam. Now if you look at the CAT section, I mean 22 questions that were there in the examination, both in 22 and 21. Okay, so we need to look at how to score a 90 percentile as such. I mean, technically, even if you are able to solve around 6 questions, okay, out of this 22, correct, you should be easily crossing the 90 percentile. Okay, 5 to 6, depending on difficulty level, it can vary from 5 to 7, but around that. Right? So I don't require too many questions. I basically require around 25% of the answers, I mean 25% of the questions get correct so that I get that percentile. Now to understand how do I get that, let's try to understand the breakup. So if you look at in the examination in the last few years, the most important topic has been arithmetic, 43% of the people has been arithmetic. Next comes in algebra, 22%. Technically if I focus on these two areas, I mean, which itself will be around 65, two-thirds of the paper, it should be sufficient for me to, you know, get through that, you know, the 22 questions. I'm sure these two sections itself will form around 14 to 15 questions of the examination. So, out of 22, around 15 questions are arithmetic and algebra. And from that 15 questions, if I'm able to get around 6 or 7 correct, around 6 correct, you should easily cross 90%. A 7 will give you a 95. That's what we are looking for. So then it makes sense to focus on these areas. I mean, also it depends on what you're comfortable with. If you're comfortable with geometry, do geometry. If you're comfortable with numbers, do numbers. But if you're comfortable with arithmetic and algebra, then focus on arithmetic and algebra and try to get those questions correct. Once you're comfortable with these topics, then you can go to other topics. So my recommendation, if you're targeting 90 plus percentile, start with focusing on arithmetic and algebra during your preparation. Be comfortable with these topics and then look at the other topics like geometry, numbers, system and modern mathematics based on your comfort level. So if you look at the theta and non-theta questions, I will have a separate video on how to tackle theta questions where I will take up a few CAT questions and look at how to solve. But going further, there are enough quant questions if you look at it, arithmetic questions, almost close to 50% to get you the target of, you technically need only 25%. Approximately, so almost, and algebra is the second highest weighted. So focus on these two areas. Don't worry about theta. A lot of people are worried about theta. Theta is hardly any 25-30% of the question, and they can be easily tackled with proper techniques. So focus on arithmetic and algebra in your preparation. Look at the other areas. I'm not saying ignore the other areas. If you're aiming for a high percentile, you should look at other areas as well, because we don't know where the easy questions can come. But yes, a little focus on these two areas if your aim is there. Topics in arithmetic, you can look at time for distance, time and work, interest, percentage, profit and loss, ratios, averages. These are supposed to be comparatively easier topics compared to other parts of the exam. Most students are comfortable with these topics purely because they've done this in the school level and they're more comfortable with it as compared to the other areas. So focus on arithmetic, that is the highest weightage in the exam. You can also look at algebra, which has linear equation, quadratic equation, higher degree equation. You can ignore, there are not too much of questions on that. You can. But yeah, ages, inequalities, functions, logs. You can look at these topics and work on those, right, for algebra. So focus on these two areas, try to get comfortable with them. So solve few sums and get the concepts needed. First of all, ensure that you focus on these two areas where you try to get the concepts and solving a few sums to get comfortable with it. Once you do that, then focus on learning new methods. If you really want to crack the exam, methods become very important. It not only helps you to get fast, be fast, but also helps you to solve the question. Because a lot of questions in the examination can be solved with simple techniques. And if you know those techniques, you can definitely crack the questions. And then practice to ensure that you reinforce those methods. It helps. I mean, practice definitely helps. Some areas, resources, obviously notes, books, videos to complete your syllabus. To learn methods, we have this Patrick K. Parshala, which we do on Wednesday, every Wednesday, live at 10:15 p.m. Look at that. There is also road to 100 questions that we put on every Wednesday and Friday. If you learn these two, go to these two, some of the techniques will be clear in terms of how to crack and how to solve the questions. Also, you can look at the CAT mocks and CAT papers so that you can practice more from them. You start with concepts from books, then methods from YouTube videos which you put up, and then apply them in the CAT mocks and CAT papers. This is how you need to progress. Hope this helped. We'll have more videos that will help you prepare for your examination. Follow us, subscribe, you will benefit. Thank you.